Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm doing about MLOps with MLflow. We are going to fine-tune an open source LLM. In this case, it will be a Mistral 7B with the library PEF from Transformers, from HuginFace, sorry, and the technique QLORA. So I have prepared a notebook as usual, like usually do. Later on I will push this notebook to the repository, and here here we are working in a Colab Pro with an A100. Probably it's not necessary to use such GPU. We don't need such big one for this training, because as you probably know, using QLORA we had less requirements in terms of the infrastructure, in terms of memory, the ones that we will use in the case that we decide to train or to fine-tune the model without the quantization and without using the ranking matrices or the LoRa technique. Again, we will use a Mistral 7 billions, the pre-trained model, version 0.1. You just need to get access, agree with the terms of use, the case that you never used it before. And we will use, obviously, we are on a series of videos on how to use MLflow. We will use the MLflow server deployed in the simplest version into the Google Colab where I'm working on today. So for this process, for this fine-tune, we will use a dataset. The dataset is this one that you have here, sorry. The BNC2 SQL Create Context is we are going to specialize the model to answer correctly SQL questions. The dataset essentially is a question. You have a question, you create you have a context. The context essentially is the information of the tables and the attributes that have this table. In this case, as you can see here, for the first row, you had the table create table head with an unique field age integer. Anyway, not very realistic, but okay, that's how it works. This table is completely useless if you don't apply something more, but okay, that's fine. And you had a question and you had the solution here. In total, the table is 78,577 examples, and you have all the documentation here about how it works. Okay, let's move. We connect the drive. We check the GPU. As you can see, I have a 140 gigabytes of memory. We install the necessary libraries. Just the integration in between MLflow and Transformer is still in experimental phase, still alpha, you can say that. So be careful if you think to apply this to a production environment. I remark that this library may change in the future. For the way that for what I see is pretty close to already, I even will say that this is not an alpha, it's a beta, and there will not be big changes in the final release. As I say in previous videos, in this series, this library is much complex, much more complex to implement and to adapt to the way that the MLflow works than others, because obviously Transformers is not only the library itself, it's other libraries like the ones we are installing here around PEF, Accelerate, Bits and Bytes. There is many things, much more complex configurations. The models are obviously more complex, and then the way that we need to train them, the kind of things that we need to be aware of are much more complex in general. So this is why it's taking more time to integrate the library with the MLflow. So, as usual, in this series, we are using the Colab Pro. We are installing the MFlow server in local. We run it with this command, with getting a IPython session and running a command on the operating system. This is acting like if you run a command in a command in a cell, in a cell, and then to redirect the traffic that the MFlow server is producing in and out in the port 5000, we are using the ngrok tool to redirect all this traffic via tunnel, encrypted tunnel, to a public IP address on this direction. I'm using the free version of this tool. You can create an account, and simply the account you get the token, and with this at least you can create a token, sorry, a tunnel to forward all everything that a application is generating in a specific port, redirected to a public IP address where you can have access. Because usually you cannot connect to a port which is behind a firewall, like this is the case with Colab Pro. Colab Pro is, at the end of the day, is a Linux box with some application server which is publishing this notebook and the UI that you see, but this is running behind an application firewall or a firewall layer, and you cannot access to all the ports that this Linux box is had opens. No? And then that's the only way to overcome this is just make a tunnel, forward the traffic of 5000 through a tunnel, and use the HTTP connect method of the proxy that is in front of this box to publish the information that we had on our on our MFlow server. We here just run the MFlow, kill any previous tunnel that we have, and create a new one, and then I got this public IP address. This is on the ngrok infrastructure, and then as you can see here, free. You can have a paid account, and then this will show more flexibility and more tunnels in concurrence, in parallel to be run it. If you had the free account, you only had one. So here we start to prepare the dataset. Essentially, we take the dataset, we load it from Hugging Face. Here we are just creating a helper to print it beautiful printing. It's just, you can see answer, question, and context. We make an split, train test, 20% for text, the rest for training. We create a prompt and mapping the a prompt function. So we just simply provide a system message, and we apply context, question, and output, the three columns, and then we apply the tokenizer. The tokenizer that we load. No, we don't apply the tokenizer yet. We just apply a mapping of the database columns to a new column with the name prompt that include the instruction that we will send to the LLM for training. We are padding left. Here you have the explanation why. We will not cover the intention of the video is not show you how to do the all the details of the fine tuning and model. We had plenty of videos in the channel how to do this with the full explanations of that. Then so I will not if you had a doubt in any case, write me a message on the channel, and I will respond you with the question with the doubt that you may have. But again, the matter of this video is to see how it works, how we can do a fine tuning using MLflow as a tracking infrastructure. Here we load the tokenizer. Max length we are going to use is 256. For the rest will be, if there is longer cutoff, it's not it's more than enough. It usually this you can see is not very big questions. For what I saw in the database, all the questions were very simple, and the contests were just creating tables, not very complicated at all. So with 256, it's approximately 256 words, more than enough. So here we apply the tokenizer to the database, to the prompt field, and we produce the input attention memory level. Take a look here, the effect of padding left. So we had the padding, which is a token with the name 2. We are using the same that the EOS token. And you can see here why, how these tokens are ignored during the training process or the fine-tuning process. Why? Because the attention max is 0. The EOS token is this one, which has an apply to 2. We prepare the model with the 4-bit quantization and LoRA, low rank adaptation. If you are interested in the, we had again several videos where we explain in detail how this work in the channel. Today I just give you the information of the relevant papers that apply to this how to say configuration. Again, 4 bits is the lowest today in May 2024, the lowest or the yeah the lowest representation available in the market. Is essentially reducing 87.5% of the memory footprint of any single parameter that you have on your model. And well, it's and the other technique is it's just a brief introduction. It's just LoRA is just well, you freeze all the weights that you had in your original model, in this case a Mistral 7B, and then you just create some additional matrices, the known RAM matrix that will be the ones that you will be really training during the process of fine tuning. Then on this produce an additional set of the weights that later on at inference times you will load together with the original model, the original Mistral 7B, and you will be using in combination with the original model to produce the inference or to generate the model, the tokens. But what you are training essentially in this using this approach is these matrices, which you will see now represent essentially, we are loading here the configuration with quantization config. We load the model, the Mistral model, and here we are doing a test essentially of the using the Vanilla model. And as you can see here, later I will explain you the parameters because I jump out into this other topic. Here we are just doing a prediction with the original model. You can see here, you can analyze the answer. The answer is wrong. It's inventing here some this game. So it's asking what is the lowest number again against Phoenix with a record of blah blah blah. So here the answer is wrong. Well, select acts start from table name 61, which is correct, where gain equal 3. This is not anywhere. So the lowest number again is the sentence. So the model here is either hallucinating in my opinion, because well, it's not probably using the temperature by default, but well, in any case, the answer is wrong. So the model is not very good in the original format to answer these questions. We create the LoRA configuration, task type casual LM, number of the rank matrices 32, LoRA alpha 64. These two values I already commented in several videos. Before there is a lot of controversy which one are the better ones. Well, some people say that it had to be the same 3232 because when the paper was released, these new models didn't exist and the parameters were explained and let's say designed for previous models. Some of the people say that you can apply the same approach that is explained on the paper. Please take a look to the paper. I read it and I didn't get a conclusion what is it. So I decided to use the recommended values and that's it. Dropout 01 and this is the target modules where we will apply the LoRa technique. So you can see here applying this to the 7 billion models which we have here, the total number of the of parameters we had. In total we are going to train only 35 millions of parameters, which mean a 1.16% of the model. We here I print just the LoRa, o sea, the path configuration, and here the configuration of the model with quantization. Here just explain one of the warnings. I was intrigued why we are receiving that, but there is, if you receive it, you have here an explanation even with the code. Even if you see in the target you receive this warning, don't worry because the path library is taking care about that. Now we create the training arguments. The only that change from the previous experience we had with training fine-tuning LLM is that you just report to MLflow. Well, here, sorry, but we connect to the tracking server, we create an experiment, and then only the training arguments, instead to report to local, to TensorFlow, we report to MLflow, and we create a running name for this run. And then the rest is conventional parameters of the trainer. Here, don't forget the padding again. Just to be sure that you pad correctly with the appropriate character or with the appropriate token, not the default one. And then we create the trainer with our path model, our tokenizer, our data set, and sorry, our data set, and a data collator with our tokenizer and the training arguments. We make a train. You can take here, and after the training, we can take a look to the experiment. And as you can see, the model just automatically, without any intervention, capture all the parameters, 216 parameters, all the metrics, all the logs of the training, and artifacts. This is done before, but you can see as well we had our signature, we had also all the model card, our metadata, which is the information that we need to deploy this model in another machine, or the environment libraries we need, Conda environment with Python 3.10 point, o sea, 3.10.12. And the path model here. As you may know, when you are training a model with this technique, you just need to save the ranking matrices because at the end of the day, you are freezing during the training the whole model. You just modify the weights of these matrices. So when you later on reuse or try to do inference, the only thing that you need to retrieve is these ranking matrices and load it together with a fresh Mistral 7 Billion version 01. And then on also obviously using the path library, and how it will work at inference time. It will use the native or the original weights of this in combination with the new learned weights that we are saving here on this small model, no? That is the ranking matrices. So again, we don't touch the original weights of the Mistral 7B. We just generate some additional matrices that later were combined with the attention heads layers of the original model. That's why here we are not saving the Mistral model, the whole Mistral model, because you can retrieve it from Hugging Face anytime. Oops, reconnect. And now, blah blah blah. So we are going to generate a template. This is to produce a signature, to infer the signature. If you remember from previous videos, we need to infer the signature to later on be able to use the Python function to load the model with a Python function and use it in a generic way, like with any other kind of model that is running under the hood. So we are going to take the first record of the dataset. We just take the prompt, so the input is going to be the prompt, the output is going to be the answer, and this is what we need. In this case, we are not going to do any generation. We just take it from the dataset, and we pass on the four parameters, and then with this we create the signature. Here, you can see the what we have on the trainer. You just take the model. It's the trainer model. It's just the PETH model. It's not the other one. It's not the Mistral 7B. And with this, we are just saving the model. We take a tokenizer, and we just load the model with save the model. As you probably remember from my previous explanations in other videos, we use the flavor transformers. Every library had a specific their own flavor. We lock the model. The transformer model is in two components. In this case, is the trainer model. Here's the PETH model. And this is the tokenizer, which we just downloaded. We pass the prompt template, which is about. Remember this. This is that one. Where is this? The prompt template. And we pass the signature. The prompt template is here. I forgot. And we pass the signature, and this is the artifact inside the run. Or also, you can take a look to this configuration of the MLflow, to the ML artifacts. This is the folder by default, and the folder where it will be everything under. It will be model as we specify here. We serialize the model, just getting here some the run ID, and here an explanation that what we will have on our meta our artifacts directory model, what we have. You can see a description of every single file. And here we are just loading the model. You can see here, if you watch the previous videos, I already have loaded about deep learning libraries, time series libraries, and transformers. We just load the model with the Python function. This is a generic function that you can use with any kind of library. The only thing that you need to respect is the process of saving the model into the model registry. And the only thing that parameters you need is the run ID of the model that you want to load. If the model was saved accordingly to what the documentation specified, that is essentially using the correct flavor, in this case transformer, and using a signature, the rest MLflow will do for you. So we load the model and we just create a prompt, and essentially you just can use the generic predict. This is applicable to any model that we load with Python function, and you produce a prompt. In any case, as I said, it's not a matter to how we if the model is performing good or better. It's probably not the better parameters to do an optimization. We can probably extend the training or increase the learning rate using another scheduler for the training rate. The matter here is show you how these two tools integrate together, transformers with MLflow, and how you, in a previous video, we see how to do different inference activities with different models from Hugging Face. And in this video, I wanted to show you how to do a fine tuning of a transformer model. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it and enjoy with this topic. I think it's quite interesting. And you can see that the tool, MLflow, that's why I think is probably the leader on this matter, on this aspect of how to leverage the machine learning lifecycle. The one of the most used of today on the market is MLflow, and in you, as you probably see, you are familiar with the tool. It's integrating with practically all the libraries that you may know, even probably more. And for those that you don't, they are not natively integrated, you can create a custom integration and it will work exactly the same. So you can extend the integrations with your own models with models from libraries that are not included in the native integrations of MLflow. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much again for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you are not subscribed yet, and give me a like if you like the content, and share with your friends and colleagues to help me to promote my channel in YouTube. Okay, thank you. See you soon.